hit the bell icon for more notifications.
Hi friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video, we are going to see MCET 2020 exam paper analysis as well as review. Okay, I'm also going to tell you what is the difficulty level of the paper, what are the most repeated topics in the exam, and on which topics you need to concentrate in order to get a good score in the exam. All these things we are going to discuss in this particular video. So make sure you watch this video till the end. Now let's begin this video without any delay. Okay, so first important thing is let's see what is the difficulty level of the paper. Coming to the difficulty level of today's paper, it is in between easy to moderate. Okay, few students told today's paper is very easy and few students told it is moderate, medium level. It's not so difficult and so easy. It's in moderate level. So the difficulty level of today's paper is considered in between easy to moderate. Okay, so now let's see what is the difficulty level subject wise. Okay, so coming to physics paper is moderate. It's not so easy and it's not so hard, but it is moderate. Coming to physics, you need to concentrate on the topics like thermodynamics, ray and wave optics. From these three particular topics, most of the questions were asked. These three chapters has really high weightage. Okay, coming to mathematics paper is also moderate and you need to concentrate on vector calculus and coordinate geometry. Most of the questions were asked from vector calculus and coordinate geometry. So concentrate on these three topics coming to mathematics. Okay, so now let's see the difficulty level of chemistry. Coming to chemistry, the paper is very easy compared to all the other subjects. Chemistry is really, really easy. And coming to chemistry, you need to concentrate on organic chemistry, chemical bonding and molecular structure. From these three topics, most of the questions were being asked. Okay, I'm repeating: organic chemistry, chemical bonding and molecular structure. Okay, so now let's see from what all chapters questions were asked in every subject. Okay, so coming to mathematics, concentrate on algebra, trigonometry, vector algebra, probability, coordinate geometry and calculus. Coming to physics, units and measurement, motion in a straight line, laws of motion, work, energy and power, gravitation, optics, thermodynamics and magnetism, current. Okay, magnetism and current, these are very most important topics coming to physics. Okay, so now let's see what are the most repeated chapters from chemistry. Okay, so coming to chemistry, atomic structure, periodic table, acid base, S and P block elements and environmental chemistry. Did you observe something? All these topics I have already given you as important, and from these topics only questions has been asked. Okay, coming to the students who have already watched my videos, I'm sure you dropped today's exam because all these topics I've already given you as important long back. So now let's see what is the process followed at the exam centers, and then let's see what all documents you are asked to carry to exam center. First, let's see what is the process which is strictly followed at exam center. This year especially, there is no biometric attendance. They are not taking attendance using biometric. They are using a face recognition technique. Using our face, they are marking attendance. Okay, they are using a tool for face recognition and marking attendance using your face. Okay, and at the exam hall, candidates need to submit the self declaration form. In my previous videos, I have already explained you, declaration form is nothing but it is a form where you will be asked a few questions such as, do you have any symptoms of this virus? Have you come across any of the person who is suffering from this virus? And do you have any flu-like symptoms? So all these questions, they'll be asked in the self-declaration form. And after filling that form, you need to give your signature and as well as your parent's signature. This is called self-declaration form and it is very important and it is must to carry self-declaration form along with you to exam center. Okay, so coming to the self-declaration form, you need to submit it in the exam center. Okay, and next is, they are thermal screening the students. They are checking the temperature of the students. If they feel the temperature is a bit high, or if they feel the students is having any kind of flu symptoms, they are not allowing students to sit in the exam hall. They are not allowing the students to attempt the exam. They are asking students to attempt the exam next day by taking the permission from superintendent. Okay, so coming to the candidates who are having this virus and who is virus positive, those particular students can also write the exam, but for them exam will be separately conducted on a separate day. You need to inform and take permission from superintendent. Okay. And we already know the morning shift timings are from 9 to 12 and from evening, and the timings of the evening shift is 3 to 6. And the good news is the students of morning shift will be allowed to the exam hall from 7:30 only, because there are so many protocols which you need to undergo. So they are putting reporting time for the shift 1 as 7:30. Okay. You can enter into the exam hall 1.5 hours before the scheduled exam time. And for the afternoon session people, that is shift 2 people, your exam is between 3 to 6, but your reporting time is 1:30. That is, you can report into the exam hall in by 1:30 itself. And the most important strict rule is, even if the student is 1 minute late, or even if the student comes 1 minute after starting of the exam, he or she is strictly prohibited from the exam. They are not allowing those students to the exam hall. So these are the very strict rules which are followed. And this is exam review and analysis. Hope you found this video useful. And I'm also going to make a video giving you the answer key. So make sure you subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that you never miss a video from Best Way to Study. And also don't forget to like and share this video with all your friends. And all the very best for the students who are going to attempt MCET, and the students who have already given the exam. Just let me know your views and how did you give your exam, all those things in the comment section below. So thanks for watching.